Welcome back to another video. I'm Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies like me and just maybe like you as well. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do something really cool if you're using something called Beaver Builder, and that's a page builder that's very powerful. Now, I think the most important aspect of any website is that you have clear calls to action, and that is telling your website visitor what the next step is that you want them to take while they're on your website. And usually you want to put that call to action in the header area of your website. That would be the top area of the website where you have your logo and your menu navigation. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to add really slick buttons like you see right now in the header area. And it even works with if your theme has a sticky nav setting. So I scroll down a little bit and the call to action stays right there. It's even going to work with that as well. Now, the way I'm accomplishing this is with a feature that's built into Beaver Builder, where you can create something, you can save it as a template, and then you can use it anywhere on your website using a shortcode. Now, the only problem with a shortcode is there's lots of areas of your website, like a menu navigation or a widget, where it doesn't accept shortcodes. So you could put it in, but it's not going to show it. So let me show you how to overcome those hurdles first. So I'm logged into the backend of WordPress here, and I'm going to go to the plugins area. Now, I already have the plugins installed, but I want to just show you the names of them. So there's two plugins that you can use. If you want to put a button or a Beaver Builder element into the menu navigation, so in this case, I'm putting this button in the menu navigation, you can accomplish that by adding a plugin called Shortcodes in Menus, and I'm going to show you how that works in a second. Now, if you want to add this shortcode to a widget area of your website, you want to use this other plugin called Shortcodes Anywhere or Everywhere. So there really isn't a lot of settings between these two plugins. First, let me show you what setting you would need to add to Shortcodes Anywhere or Everywhere. And let me just preface, these are free plugins. They're available. If you just go to plugins, add new, and do the search for them, you're going to find them. There's no cost to adding these plugins to your site. So first, let's look at Shortcodes Anywhere. So I've got to go to settings, Shortcodes Anywhere or Everywhere. I'm going to click on that. And right here, you have to enable or disable where you want these shortcodes to actually work. So for me, in widgets, you would have to click on in widgets and then click on this checkbox right here. But this makes it so that you could use these shortcodes in all sorts of different places. I just enabled the in widgets right there. So, and by default, of course, your shortcodes are going to work in pages and posts. So let me show you how I did it in the menu. Now, the first thing you want to do is actually create and save whatever element that Beaver Builder produces that you want. You need to create and save it as a module, a saved module. So I've shown you how to do that in prior videos, and I might as well just go into it right now. But you need to have this enabled, the templates in Beaver Builder. So if you don't have this templates link, you need to go to settings, page builder, and then you need to click on right here where it says templates, and you need to check on this box. That will get you this templates section right here. Now, when you're in Beaver Builder, let me go into Beaver Builder page. You can save anything and it will save it to templates. Let me just do this real quick. It'll be really fast for those of you that already know how to do this. I'm jumping into a page in Beaver Builder right here. So see, this is a button. All you would have to do is click on it, and then right here, click on Save As, and then put a name. That's all you have to do in order to save something that you've created in Beaver Builder. So you would basically create a button, save it as a module, and then tweak the settings however you wanted it. So I've actually already done that. So let me get out of the page editor here. and show you the button that I created. So I'm just going to go back into the admin, go to templates, and it's right here. It's called CTA button. CTA, the acronym for call to action. So when you click on it and then click on launch page builder, this will allow you to tweak the button to make it look however you want. Now I have it right aligned. You can tweak the alignment of the button. And actually we need to do that a little bit here because the button is a little too close to the normal navigation here. So we can put a little padding here on the left. So why don't I do that now? So here's the button. I'm gonna click on it to be able to change its settings. And I'm gonna click on advanced. And I'm gonna add a little bit of margin here on the left. Let's say maybe 20 pixels or something like that. Now, this is a saved module. And what I've noticed is when you have a saved module and you insert it someplace with a short code, that Beaver Builder adds some padding that you're probably gonna wanna remove. So let me save this button. But before I do, I'm using the button module that is found in Ultimate Add-ons for Beaver Builder. I have a link on that down below. It adds this really slick dual button feature that I like, but you can change a lot of things like the padding here around the button. And other, you could just control all of it, but I'm just gonna leave it standard here. So let me go ahead and click on save. Now, I was just saying a moment ago that Beaver Builder adds a little bit of padding when you're using a saved module as a shortcode. So you have to put a little bit of CSS in to remove that. So if I go to Tools and then click on Layout CSS, here's what I added, and I can add this below, but if you're comfortable with CSS, it'll be real easy for you to do. But it's basically -flbuilder-module-template to make the padding zero so it doesn't put any padding around it. You're gonna need to do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on save. And remember I made that little adjustment here to the margin, so let me click on done and publish those changes. Okay, so now let me show you how to take this and insert it anywhere that will accept shortcodes. And first we'll go to the menu. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on dashboard. I'm gonna click on templates. Now we need to find something called the slug of this saved module. So I'm gonna click here where it says CTA button, and right here is the slug, CTA button. So I'm gonna highlight and I'm gonna copy this into my clipboard. Now if you don't see this slug area, you would have to click on screen options and then check on the box. So this is how it might look for you, but once you check the box, now you have that slug information. So now I'm gonna go to appearance, and then I'm gonna go to menus, and here is my main menu. You can see I've already added it here, but let me just remove it. Okay, so here is the menu. Now, if you've activated the shortcodes and menus, you're gonna have this new option here that says shortcode. So you could do drop down and give it a name. This name isn't used anywhere. It's just so you would be able to identify it if you had a big menu. So I'm gonna just call it a button like that. And then I'm gonna put my shortcode here. Now in my prior videos, I went through how to do this shortcode thing with Beaver Builder. And I'll make sure I put a link down below this video. It's also, I have a Beaver Builder resources page on my website. I'll have a link to that below that covers everything related to Beaver Builder, including this shortcode. So let me show it to you. So this is the format of the shortcode right here, and I could paste this anywhere for you. And this part here where it says slug, insert post slug, that's where we need to take that slug we just got out of the saved module. So let me paste that in. And now I can click add to menu, and you're gonna see it just added it right there. And then I'm gonna click on save menu. Now I am going to do a refresh. Now remember I added a little bit of margin here because I felt like the nav was a little too close to the button. So if I do a refresh, you see how it pushed it out a little bit. And that's kind of what I was going after. Now a few caveats with using shortcodes in menus to plug in. I don't think it has to do with the plugin. It's just the way that themes are coded. Now in some themes, the way you have your button set up, it will still inherit the styles of that area. And what I mean is, even though I'll set a font for the plug for this button here, and I might set a font size and some different settings, it's still going to inherit whatever we have the font and the font size be for the menu. Unfortunately, there is some inheriting that goes on. I'm sure there's a way to overcome that using CSS, but that's just the way that it is right now. But you can see how easy that was to add a button to the navigation. Now, here's some neat things that you could do with this, okay? So with the Beaver Builder theme, or a lot of themes, there's different ways that you can style your navigation, meaning you have your logo on the left and you have your menu on the right, or maybe you can have the logo on the left and then the menu underneath it. Now, typically, if it's a local business, a good menu format is to have your logo on the left, your menu underneath it, and that leaves this space, this clear empty space on the right of your header where you can put these call to actions right there, phone numbers, hours, whatever information that clearly is displayed and you're telling that person that's on your website what you want them to do next. So that is where these short codes in the menu, short codes in widgets are really powerful when you pair it up with Beaver Builder, because now you can easily design a beautiful area there to take up that white space. And you see this on some websites you go to where it will have the hours and the phone number and different things like that, and it looks really nice. So that's where these short codes for Beaver Builder are super powerful when you pair it up with one of these free plugins that allows you to use those short codes anywhere on your site that is non-typical area to use a short code. So that is it for this video. I hope you find some real creative uses for this as I have. Hey, really quick, can you do something for me? If you're watching this on YouTube, can you give me a thumbs up? And I want to invite you to subscribe to this YouTube channel. There's a button right beneath me, and I'd really appreciate it if you did that. And I've got something for you. I don't want you to leave empty-handed. If you just click off here to the side, it's a free video course that I put together just for you called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. You will love this course. Registration is free right now. All you have to do is click on the link right next to me. Hey, thanks for spending this time with me, and I can't wait to make another video for you.